let's talk about data sonification. I'm going to borrow Carlo Scaletti's definition of data sonification, mapping from data to one or more parameters of an audio signal or sound synthesis model for the purpose of better understanding, communicating, or reasoning about the original model, experiment, or system. So generally what we're doing here is we're taking quantitative information, a whole stream of numbers, and then using sound to help improve our understanding of that data, of those numbers. Now, a few disclaimers, because data sonification is easy to misunderstand, and quite frankly, sometimes how it's presented in the media isn't helpful. So for example, I have a series of videos on data bending. I'm taking data that's not intended to be an audio file and just playing it back. And while technically we are sonifying files when we data bend, it's a bit of a stretch to call this data sonification. We're not trying to improve our understanding of that data. The data there really isn't from an experiment or anything else. It's more akin to just random numbers than meaningful experimental data. I also talked about data-driven instruments before, and in the case of data-driven instruments, we're intentionally performing data. We're running our finger across an iPad, we're moving a mouse, we're pushing down on a Hawken continuum with a distinct pressure. We're intentionally creating the data for the point of musical expression. It's important to recognize that the point of data sonification is generally not to produce music. Back to Scaletti's definition, her quote continues, "Although data sonification shares techniques and materials with data-driven music, it's in the interest of the practitioners of both music composition and data sonification to maintain a distinction between the two fields." Now, there are some pieces that integrate sonification of data for artistic expression, but in general, it's kind of a straw man to listen to data sonification and say, "Oh, that doesn't sound very good," because that's not what most are trying to present through their sonification. Article titles like "Scientists Have Turned the Structure of the Coronavirus into Music" aren't necessarily helpful in dispelling these myths. But of course, that doesn't mean there isn't real science going on here. We use a lot of tricks to help us understand data, drawing charts, drawing graphs, and so the purpose of data sonification can be similar to these. It can help us perceive patterns in the data, it can help us perceive trends, it can perhaps help us communicate ideas to others, again, much in the same way that our data visualization does. So when we're going to sonify data, what do? Instead of drawing lines that go up and down, portions of charts that get bigger and smaller, we need to think about what characteristics of sounds we can avail ourselves of. I always come back to the five characteristics of sound: pitch, loudness, timbre, spatial location, and duration. And then we can build out from these with density of rhythm, perhaps tempo, or other relationships between these aspects of sound. So then what we can do is we can take our numbers and then map them to these characteristics of sound. We could map the numbers to the loudness. Map the numbers to pitch. Map numbers to an aspect of timbre. Or if we have multiple streams of data, we could map different dimensions of sound to these different dimensions of data. What's important though is when you sonify, you are making these choices. When you listen to a sonification of, again, the coronavirus, that's not what the coronavirus sounds like. It's aspects of that coronavirus mapped to somewhat arbitrary sonic dimensions. You could take a set of data, and you could map that same data to very, very different sonic dimensions and get a different sonic result. Again, the apparent arbitrariness of the sonic results aren't a problem. They're a feature. Sonification is attempting to communicate ideas, just in the same way that visualizations of data or even language are trying to communicate ideas. What's important here, again, is not whether it's beautiful music or not. It's whether we're able to find some sort of insight from this data, from this presentation of it. So an effective use of sonification, then, perhaps, can be judged on these aspects of communication. Is it communicating truth? Is it effectively representing the data? And is it facilitating understanding?